Video number one of our next chapter, chapter C, we will be doing some classifying of triangles by two things, by two types of measures, by their side lengths and by their angle measures. And there is a connection between side measures and the angle measures, which we will discuss at the very end of this chapter. So this will be a very, very short video. So if we were wanting to classify triangles by their angle measurement, now, we have used the term acute before to describe one specific angle that is less than 90 degrees. Well, there is such thing as an acute triangle. And the definition of an acute triangle is where all three of our angles will be less than 90 degrees. So you don't just have one acute angle, you don't have two acute angles, but all three angles of our triangle must be acute. And if you have three acute angles, you have an acute triangle. An obtuse triangle. Now, the correlation does not necessarily go hand in hand here like it does with acute, but with obtuse, it only takes one angle to be bigger than 90 degrees. Okay, an obtuse angle was just an angle that was bigger than 90, so an obtuse triangle now, a whole obtuse triangle has to have one angle that's bigger than 90. So just by looking at this picture, it looks like it's probably going to be this angle right here that is greater than 90. Now, what must be true about the other two angles? The other two angles will end up being acute angles. They have to be acute. They cannot all three be obtuse. One thing that we will discuss in the next video is that triangles have 180 degrees altogether. And if we have three obtuse angles, that means we'll have three angles that are bigger than 90, which means our triangle will have over 270 degrees, which would be impossible. So an obtuse triangle just has one obtuse angle. A right triangle means that we need to have a right angle, and a right angle has exactly 90 degrees. So either you'll see the number 90, or you'll see our right angle box, like right here. So again, that is a right triangle because it has a right angle in it. And then last but not least, an equiangular. This almost seems like a made-up word, but it's an actual word. Equiangular means that all three angles are equal to each other. And the only way that that can work out in a triangle is if all three angles are equal to, specifically, 60 degrees. Because 60 plus 60 plus 60 will give us our 180 that we'll talk more in depth about in our next problem, or in our next video, sorry. Now, an equiangular triangle also technically could be called something else that we have already talked about. Since we have three 60-degree angles and 60-degree angles are all acute, technically an equiangular triangle could also be considered an acute triangle as well. So those two terms can kind of go hand in hand. If it's equiangular, it's acute. But if it's an acute triangle, it may or may not be equiangular, if and only if the angles are all 60. Now we're going to switch gears and focus on the side length. So again, hopefully you guys have heard of these before in another math class once upon a time. A scalene triangle has no congruent sides. All three sides have to be different lengths, okay? So earlier when we were doing angles, we were on the inside of the triangle, but now we're going to be on the outside looking at the lengths. So I could call this maybe 3, maybe this 4, and maybe this 6. All three of these sides are of different length value, and they would be called scalene. An isosceles triangle has two sides that are the same. Now, one, two ways that you'll see that. Either you'll specifically see the same number used twice to represent the same length, or we're going to go back and use our congruent side markings, okay? And they were placed in the middle of a side. Okay, out of this whole side, these markings are about in the middle. And out of this whole side, these markings are about in the middle. And notice they use the same number of markings. Since there are two markings here, there are two markings here. Could we have gotten by with only using one set of markings? Sure, we could have. We could have used three markings on both of these. As long as they have the same number of markings, that means that they are the same length. And equilateral. Equilateral just means that all of the sides, all three sides, are the same. So notice on all three of these sides, they all have the same marking on them. They all have one marking, which means that they are all the same value. So you'll either see the markings or you'll see specific numbers, like maybe they're all sevens. Therefore, it is equilateral. So we're going to look at two examples real quick. So this one says, classify the triangle by its angles and by its sides. So we're going to, for its sides, we're going to use the last three terms, either equilateral, isosceles, or scalene. And then by angles, we're going to use equiangular, right, obtuse, or acute. So if we start with angles, here are all three angles. Okay, so let's see, all three of these angles are, well, they're all less than 90 degrees, so they're all acute. Are they all the same? No, they're not all the same. These two are the same, but the 36 is different. So this is an acute triangle based on its angle measures. Now, based on its sides, this is where it's going to be scalene, isosceles, or equilateral. If we look at the side measures, we don't have any specific numbers, but we see that these two sides are the same, and the last side is not. So based on the side measurements, where two of them are the same, this would also be considered an isosceles triangle. Now, we can put all of this together if we wanted to, and we could call it an acute, comma, isosceles triangle. Okay, so a triangle can have two names. One name is for its angle, and the other name is for its side length. So the last one here, let's do the same thing, based on its angles and its sides. Let's start with the angles. If we look at all three angles, if I look at all three angles, I notice, hey, this guy kind of stands out. It's bigger than 90, so therefore this thing must be an obtuse triangle, and I'm just going to draw in a little triangle symbol to represent the word triangle. And then if I look at these side measures, I got 6.4, 5.8, and 9. And none of those sides are the same. Therefore, I would call that scalene. So now if I wanted to combine everything together, I could call this an obtuse, comma, scalene triangle. If I can spell triangle here. There we go. An obtuse scalene triangle. I could have said scalene obtuse triangle. It doesn't really matter the order that you put these two in, as long as you identify both of them, as long as they're asking for both angles and sides. Now, what I really want you to do is to complete the WIA that is right after this video on my website. It's just one problem, and it's very similar to what we just did two times. So again, I want you to take this triangle and identify it by its angles and its sides. So follow the link, write in the two names, the one for its angles and one for its sides, and you've completed the WIA. That is all for video number one.